Hi, everybody. We're here on level two of the silo. This is where all the tours come. So if you've taken a tour, you have been right here. I want to take a minute to talk about something that we don't usually have time to talk about on the regular tour, but we get asked about it all the time, and we kind of do the best we can to distill it down to a few seconds. But that involves, the questions involve this big platform right here. And often they involve this porthole here. And of course, we get questions on this big pipe in the wall here as well. These three things are all part of the same system. So here's the story. The guidance system for Titan II was upgraded in 1979. Prior to 1979, the gyroscopes on the missile Gyroscopes on the missile had to have a constant reference for their azimuth. Let's just say a constant reference for north. And that reference was provided by this thing. It's a photograph of it. It's called the Azimuth Alignment Set Autocollimator. And that thing sat on this platform right here. And on the front of it, there's a lens. See that big lens? And that lens shot a beam of light from the platform through that porthole. And the porthole looks into what was then an open hatch on the side of the missile. You can see the hatch right there. I'll go over to the window and give you a better look at it. There's the hatch. Let me see if I can zoom in on that. Sorry for the shaking here. There it is zoomed in. It's called the Imu Sighting Center. And the Imu is where all the gyroscopes are on the missile. And so on the Imu, there's a prism, and the prism picks up that beam of light and shoots it back to the autocollimator, and it gets compared. And if the beams don't line up precisely, it means the gyroscopes are drifting. So then the autocollimator would send an automatic command to the inertial measurement unit to realign the gyros. 24/7, they did that all the time. Now, the autocollimator itself needs periodic calibration. And to do that, you go topside and you find the other end of this pipe. It's underneath a hatch in the ground. We can show it to you in another video. And you open the hatch and you set up your surveyor's instrument. It's called a theodolite. So the surveyor's set up the theodolite, and they take a bearing on two monuments that are about 1,100 feet away in the desert that were put there for that purpose. And they get a bearing on those monuments, and then somehow they take their theodolite and those numbers, and they swivel it around, and they point it down through this pipe where they can line it up with some crosshairs or something on the autocollimator to align that, and then you're done. But they had to do that every 6 months. When the new guidance system was installed, all of this stuff was abandoned because it was no longer required. This used to be a separate room. This wall right here used to come out to where the window is now. There was a man door, a regular man door in the wall. This wall right here came out, did kind of a U-turn, a kind of a right angle, I should say, and connected to the silo launch duct wall right here. You can actually see little places where it used to be attached. And then there's a separate, or there used to be a separate air conditioner for this room on this platform right here, so that all the optical things on the autocollimator were always kept at a constant temperature. And this is really vital. Accuracy of this thing was really vital in the missile finding its way to the target. So I hope that's somewhat of an explanation for you. Thanks for watching.